Good morning, student. Myself, Professor Gada Keses from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yeovil. Student, we are learning the final year subject, that is the solar and wind energy. So, up to the last lecture, we have seen some topics from the unit number 4, that is a case study on the solar energy application. That means, in the unit number 4, we have to see the 3 case studies related to the solar energy application. So let's see which are that 3 case studies which we have to see. First case study we have to see, that is related to the solar food dryer. That means how solar energy is used in the drying system, food drying system, that we have to study. Second one, case study is related to the parabolic dish solar cooker. That means how solar energy is used for the parabolic dish cookers, that we have to study. And at the last, case study 3 is related to the photovoltaic system. So, how that photovoltaic system is using the solar energy, that we have to learn. So, up to the last lecture, from first case study, we have discussed some topics, that are basics of solar dryers, then basic principle, that is working principle of solar dryer, then use of the solar dryer also we have seen, different uses of the solar dryer we have seen. Then 3 types of solar dryers we have seen. There are so many types of solar dryers are there, but generally 3 types of solar dryers we are using. That are natural convection solar dryer, forced convection solar dryer, and tunnel type solar dryer. So that details you will see from the last video. Those who have not seen that video, you can see that, and then you will continue the same video. So, in the today's topic, the remaining topic we are going to cover, that's our application of solar dryer, advantages of solar dryer, disadvantages of solar dryer, and then we are going to continue at the last actual study of the solar dryer. That means, we have to study the actual case study of the solar food dryer, how that solar food dryer is working, that we are going to see. So let's see applications of the solar dryer. So what they have said about the application, these are also commonly referred to as a food, cloth or crop dryer. That means that a dryer, solar dryer are referred for the food drying, cloth drying and crop drying also. Based on these atoms used for drying using the solar dryer, many people can assemble or construct solar dryer with the help of DIY instructions available on the internet. That means you can assemble the solar dryer, that means natural convection dryers or forced convection dryer, you can assemble at the home, okay, by the using of instruction of DIY that you will get from the internet also. The image shown above is the self-explanatory. That means I have explained one image in the last lecture that is related to the solar drying system. Solar dryer will find increased application in the food, agriculture and plantation industries where food and crop atoms needs to be dry before using. That means once you know the dried food is able to preserve for a long time than the wet food. All of you know that. So, if you want to preserve the food for the larger time, you have to dry that foods. It helps in maintaining the quality of these atoms without contaminations of the any external fears. In economies where people hardly have power for their daily lives, these devices will help a great deal in reducing the load on the main grid, and electricity from the grid can be used for the other purpose. All of you understand? That means that solar dryer, with the help of solar dryer, that's our natural convection or forced convection. So in the natural convection we don't require the fans also. Then we are directly using the heated air for the drying purpose. That means the load on the grid or electricity will get reduced due to the solar dryer. So that's are some applications where solar energies or solar dryer are used. Then we are going to see different advantages of the solar dryer. So let's see which are the advantages of solar dryer. The solar dryer helps to retain the nutrients, taste, color, odor, prevent infection and to preserve the agro produces. All of you understand? That means solar dryer. So if we preserve the food with the help of solar dryer, it will not affect on the nutrient, taste, color, odor, its agro products also. All of you understand that? So that's are the benefits of using the solar dryer. Solar energy is free and clean source of energy. That means though we are using the solar energy, but we know that is a free energy. So there will be no expenses on the income. All of you understand? So solar dryer are more economical compared to the dryer that runs on the conventional fuel or electricity. That means conventional dryers are using the electricity or using the another fuel for drying the foods. But as compared to that, solar dryers, that input energy is free. That's why that's are more economical than the conventional dryers. The drying process is completed in the most hygienic and eco-friendly way. That means there will be no side effect on the food which we are going to drying by the solar dryer. Solar drying system have low operation and maintenance cost. That means operation and maintenance cost is lower on because all the parts are simple. That is the advantages of the solar dryer. Solar dryer last longer. That means they are longer time. They are survive for longer time. So a typical dryer can last 15 to 20 years with the minimum maintenance. That means once you install the solar dryer, it will work for 15 to 20 days. And simple maintenance will be there, but no large maintenance will be there. That means that's the economical or affordable to the common people also. So that's are the advantages of solar dryer. But those advantages are there, along with that advantages, disadvantages or limitations are also there for the solar dryer. So let's see which are the disadvantages or limitations of the solar dryer. So first, the disadvantage is that drying can be performed only during the sunny days unless the system is integrated with the conventional energy based system. That means if your system is conventional energy based system, you will able to dry the foods only in the sunny days. So if your climate is not good enough to get the sunlight, then you will not able to dry the foods with the natural conventionally energy based source. Next disadvantage is that due to limitations of solar energy collection, the solar drying process is slow in comparison with the dryers that use the conventional fuels. That means solar energy is free. That point also we have discussed. Due to the input energy is free, that is more economical than the other conventional fuels dryers. Normally solar dryers can utilize only for drying at 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. That means we are drying the food up to 40 to 50 degrees Celsius. So that's some disadvantages or limitations of the solar dryer. In the next lecture, we are going to see actually how that solar dryer is working for the drying the food. So next topic we will continue in the next lecture.